Please welcome Dr. Elisa Stevens, President of the Academy of Art University.
Welcome everybody tonight. And I'd like to thank you for all attending the Academy of Art University School of Fashion Portfolio Review and Graduation Fashion Show. You know, my grandfather started this school in 1929, almost 90 years ago. And he was a painter and art director for Sunset Magazine, and my grandmother ran the school, the books. And they had one son, my father, and he took over the school. And he and I have been working together for almost 30 years. And when we started working together, the School of Fashion was the smallest school that we had. We've got over 100 programs and 15,000 students. But the School of Fashion was the smallest. And it is now the largest program that we have. It's the number one school, I feel confident in saying, in the world. And we wanted it to be number one, and we worked hard. And the way we were able to do it is with people like Simon Unglis and all of our wonderful instructors. So I want to thank all of them for really making my dad and my dream for this program come true. We're here to celebrate the exceptional hard work that the students and soon-to-be graduates in this room have shown. And we know that they work hard, that they are dedicated, and that they are driven. They would not be here otherwise. Their portfolios impress me, and I find myself inspired because they are the future of the fashion industry. I hope you enjoyed meeting them as well. And for those of you who work in the industry that are here sharing opportunities, creating industry projects, and recruiting and offering internships and jobs, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. We want them to succeed. I know that we provide the tools to do so, and we are committed to providing real-world experience in our labs, our studios, and our classrooms. We create group projects like the design teams they will be a part of in their first internship and their job. So we encourage collaboration as they are a crucial aspect of the professional world. You're going to see 10 collaborations on the runway tonight. 3 fashion design and knitwear design collaborations, of which one is a menswear collection. 1 fashion design and costume design collaboration. 4 fashion design and jewelry and metal arts collaborations. 3 fashion design and textile design collaborations, of which one is menswear. Another example that defines the spirit of collaboration has been placed on every chair in this room. And you are the first to see the 9th issue of the 180 magazine that has been created through collaborations between students in the various areas of study within this university. Since launching in 2008, the 180 magazine has profiled a different department at the Academy in each of its issues. And in this issue, it includes the School of Fine Art and introduces the Director of Sculpture, Tom Durham, who curated the work of Academy Sculpture students here in this venue tonight as you walked in. Another example of collaboration is located at 657 Sutter Street, named Shop 657, a retail space created and curated by fashion merchandising and visual merchandising students. In Shop 657, you will find clothing, shoes, accessories, decorative lifestyle items designed by Academy students, alumni, and faculty. And I invite you to go shopping at the Shop 657. We would like to announce awards and scholarships tonight, of which there are many. As there are quite a few to announce, I would like to ask that you hold your applause to the end. Sarah Kozlowski is the Director of Education and Professional Development for the Council of Fashion Designers of America. And I'm pleased to have Sarah join us tonight and would like to welcome her to the podium.
Thank you so much, Dr. Stevens, and thank you, Simon, and your entire team for having me here today. It's a pleasure. And it's a true pleasure to announce I have about 28 soon-to-be graduates to congratulate and a few third years. But the CFDA is very proud to congratulate these students for our scholarship program. We, this year, are inviting finalists to present live to CFDA member-based selection committee. So many of these names that I'll be sharing in a moment will be soon traveling to New York, so I hope to see them later this week. For the primary CFDA scholarship, I'd like to congratulate Pamela Toribio of Textile Design. For the Liz Claiborne Scholarship, I'd like to congratulate Susan Zienti. And for the Jeffrey Bean Scholarship, which is now offered exclusively to graduate students celebrating 3D design, congratulations to Yun-Suk Lee. These talents were selected from more than 160 portfolios from 20 of America's leading design programs. So it's a great honor to have them join us at the CFDA. And for the Kenneth Cole Footwear and Innovation Award, Erica Thompson and Yun Hui Zhang have been selected as finalists to present to Kenneth Cole and a selection committee. And they're working towards a one-year design fellowship in New York for the year ahead. And then next, at the CFDA, we're proudly partnering with the City of New York on a new showcase called Fashion Future Graduate Showcase, which brings together 85 talents from 5 amazing schools, including Academy of Art University, joining RISD and New York School's Pratt Parsons FIT. And we've selected 85 talents, and happy to say that 23 of those talents are from AAU, and will be participating in a digital and physical showcase, both on CFDA.com and in New York. So I know, please bear with me, I apologize if I mispronounce any of these wonderful talents' names, but congratulations to Asta Shah, Alvin Eng, Amanda Niamachi Velasquez, Binan Han, Bom Kim, Boem Tiang, Brandy Puket, Carly Dean, Christina Yun Tian, Dagny Stiandur Dotur, I'm so sorry, Dina Marie Lam, Eden Slezen, Erica Tompkins, Estine Marquez, Helen Zhao, Jessica Victoria Weihaya, Jiren Xia, Laura Hideka, Nancy Diao, Rihanna Oliver Palanca, Sahara Aldrich, Zhu Yi Chen, and Xiao Yu Zhao. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sarah. And now we have a few more that I'm going to announce, so I'd ask you to please hold your applause. The YMA Fashion Scholarship Fund Jeffrey Bean National Scholarship Award for $10,000 goes to Amanda Velasquez. And Amanda's name was called twice at last year's show. She was awarded the YMA Fashion Scholarship Fund FSF $5,000 scholarship, and she also won Joe's Black Book Scholarship for Best Women's Wear Portfolio. The FSF $5,000 scholarship winners are Alora Martinez and Hee-Young-Ji Lee. For SureTex International Student Design Competition Design Next winner, Jiran Shea, and the San Francisco Paris Sister City Scholarship Exchange in Paris, France, Studio Berceau, goes to Amanda Velasquez, Ruth Renaga, and Kahana Klebanoff. L'École de la Chambre Syndicale de la Couture Parisienne goes to Jessica Ouijeya and Amy Shizu Chen. And the 2017 Top Fashion Journalism Students iPad Mini Courtesy of Flipboard goes to Navitha Sundar, Isabella Urbina, and Keha Montgomery. The Academy of Art University Social Media Center 2017 Scholarship Award, sponsored by Cross Marketing Public Relations, in the first place is a $1,500 scholarship and internship with Cross Marketing Public Relations goes to Farnaz Darashi. And the second place internship with Cross Marketing Public Relations goes to Navitha Sundar. The Academy of Art University Fashion Journalism 2017 Scholarship Award, sponsored by TRC Public Relations and Marketing. The first place $1,000 scholarship and internship with TRC Public Relations and Marketing, Navitha Sundar. Congratulations. Second place $500 in internship with TRC Public Relations and Marketing goes to Catherine Zerbe. And third place internship with TRC Public Relations and Marketing, Paula Bozuk. Okay, now they definitely deserve a big round of applause. Now's the time. I'd like to list some of the accomplishments of our guest of honor here tonight, Sarah Moer. She received the distinguished honor of member of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. She is chief critic for Vogue.com. She is an internationally acclaimed fashion journalist who has written reviews and features for such publications as Style.com, Vogue, British Vogue, and Harper's Bazaar. She is the author of 6 books. As the British Fashion Council's ambassador for emerging talent, she co-chairs their New Gen Committee and serves as a trustee of their education foundation, where she campaigns to raise much-needed scholarships for students. Sarah Moer, we are profoundly moved by your contribution to the fashion industry, to fashion education, and for your support of emerging designers. And at this time, please step forward to receive the honor of Doctorate of Humane Letters from the Academy of Art University. So now the magic words. Sarah Moer, by virtue of the authority granted by the charter to the Academy of Art University from the state of California, and by the powers vested in me by the governing board, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctorate of Humane Letters with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto, and thank you for your contribution to the arts.
Dr. Stevens and the Academy of Art University, I cannot say how overwhelmed I am by this honor. I've worked in this industry as a journalist for over 30 years, in fact, and I got into it because I'm interested in the future.
Yes.
I can't get my notes. I'm also the daughter of teachers, art teachers, and I know and value how much education means, how much teachers put into education, and I'd like you to all give a round of applause to Simon Unglis and his team for the extraordinary work he's put into your life.
massive congratulations to every single student who's graduating tonight. I know how much work goes into producing any collection. Fashion is not a job, it's a life, and you already have committed to that. Moreover, your parents, your guardians, anybody who's sponsored you also deserves a round of applause, and especially all those who have paid for themselves to come to this extraordinary establishment. So, congratulations. As a journalist, as I said, I'm only interested in the future. Fashion journalism is always living in the future. And I'm also very interested in the past, in the significance of the past, and how patterns are repeated. I've been so interested here in San Francisco. It's the first time I've been here. This morning, I went with my daughter to the Summer of Love exhibition at the De Jong Museum. I recommend that everybody goes, because in that exhibition is a really important message. A whole culture came out of here, as you know, 50 years ago, an uprising, a political uprising of young people who decided that something needed to change, and they changed the world in the face of a very bleak situation. And I take that as an incredibly important message from this city, which is a city which influences the world still with, of course, the tech industries here. San Francisco is a place which influences the world, and the people who graduate from this place have that in their bones now that you've studied here for 3 or 4 years. My message to you is, perhaps this seems like a bleak and difficult time, but in these times, interesting cultural things always rise up, and I know that they will rise up from you. I really want to know what you think and what you are going to do together, possibly as a community, with your friends that you've made here. Use your creativity and use your voice, and enjoy your next steps.
Another little thing for you.
Right.
So Sarah, we have one more thing for you. The mayor of San Francisco, Mayor Lee, is very sorry he could not be here tonight. However, he wanted me to read the certificate of honor be presented to you, and I'm going to read what that certificate says. Whereas on behalf of the City and County of San Francisco, I am pleased to recognize and honor Sarah Moore for receiving the degree of Doctorate of Humane Letters from the Academy of Art University, and your contributions to the fashion industry and fashion education and your support of emerging designers is truly commendable. You're an acclaimed fashion journalist and author, presently chief critic at Vogue. You have received the distinguished honors by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II for your role in raising the British fashion industry in the global community. You have also co-chaired the British Fashion Council's Ambassador for Emerging Talent. And San Francisco commends you for your tremendous contribution to fashion education and advocacy for students and young designers. Congratulations and best wishes on your future endeavors. Therefore, I have hereunto set my hand and caused the seal of the City and County of San Francisco to be affixed. Edwin M. Lee, Mayor.
So honored. Thank you so much to Mayor Edwin Lee. That this is extremely unexpected, and thank you so much. And now on with the show.
Thank you, Sarah. And now, what we've been waiting for, let the show begin.
for you. I buy this girl a nice car. It's like about 2 or 3 years after we broke up. She says to me, "You wanna buy that car back off me? You wanna buy that car back off me?" When she moved in, I had over 13 grand in my checking account. A year later, we broke up, and I was negative 7,000. I bought her a motorcycle, I bought her a bus, I bought her a van, I paid the rent.
Intrínseca combinação de detalhes. Stand right. but you can't forget from sundown to sunset. Nah, nah. It's all in the air, you hear it everywhere. No matter what you do, it's gonna grab a hold on you. Grab a hold on you. Grab a hold on you.
Congratulations, graduates of the School of Fashion. But let's get Simon out here to take a bow and the rest of the team. Thank you. Academy of Art University, School of Fashion, thank you for a great show. And thank you all for coming tonight. Good night. Good night.